Hey, I'm Florian Kohler from Venom Trick Shots, and today we're gonna do another mesque tutorial. We covered some masse at first. We're gonna do stroke shots. This one in particular is a lot of people really wanna know how it's made, so I figured I'm gonna show it to you. I'm gonna go and put a triangle right there, so it's basically right by the edge of the angle here, so you don't want to put too close because you want the ball to go in, but you don't want to put it too far because you won't want to hit the point. So just cover that point and you're safe, just like that. So I use a delta triangle because they're metal, but you could do the same with a wooden triangle. It would just a little bit tougher to stay in place. So I'm gonna move here. So all you need for that shot is basically three balls. So we're gonna do a combo 9-2 here, just like that. So remember, like every combo shot, the only reason the two ball is there is to make the target bigger. Because, you know, if you just have one ball, it's much more difficult if you have two. So in that case, you know, the whole target is out there. So instead of having just one little spot to hit, you got a half diamond zone to basically hit the ball. So frozen 2-9, nine about to fall. We're gonna go here, and this is where it gets interesting. So I'm gonna freeze the cue ball about to the second diamond. So you just line up the cue ball into the second diamond right here. And then we're gonna put the one ball. So for the one ball, you don't wanna be straight. You wanna have a little bit of an angle. So if I'm gonna go and I'm setting it up, I usually put my cue about in the middle of the cue ball and the one ball, just like that. And it kinda goes towards half the diamond. So it's not entirely half the diamond, but it's really close to it. You're gonna adjust a little bit depending on stroke too. So, but I would say aim these balls into the half diamond there. All right? So obviously the one ball's not frozen to the rail. And the next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna leave a space between the cue ball and the one ball. So two things. If the cue ball is frozen to the one ball, the shot won't work. If the cue ball is too far from the one ball, the shot won't work. So you're gonna need to have a perfect, basically, gap. It's about a quarter inch usually, like 5 millimeters, something like that. Just like that, I'm gonna make sure it's in spot. And that's basically it. So again, the setup's pretty easy. Triangle, cue ball, one ball, 2 and 9, all of that. The stroke, however, is very difficult. So for that shot, I use another mess cue. I actually use my exceed cue here. So I also have a 2-inch extender on it because it's helping me to get straight. The shaft is a little more flexible than the normal pull cue simply because it's a spinner tip. I think this one's about 11.5 millimeter. It's a normal ferrule. It's just a simple maple wood here. We can, you know, you can buy it just like that. So the only reason it's more flexible is because the tip is, you know, much smaller than usual. The key on that shot is to hit the cue ball not too low, not too high, and not much right spin. So a lot of people think you have to hit left spin. Because you're frozen to the rail, you really can't hit the left spot. As you can see, you know, you would have to go right here, which is very bad. So the key is to hit straight in line pretty much. So you know I told you aim pretty much for the half diamonds. You're gonna do pretty much the same thing right here. So you're gonna aim full into the one ball. If anything, maybe a little bit on the right side of the one ball there. So I'm kind of going into the half diamond there, and I'm gonna do basically just a tip of draw, a touch of right spin, and you're gonna follow through all the way. Your cue ball is gonna draw back into the two. The difficult part is you have to have a pretty quick stroke. Usually I like to have a very loose grip on the back. It's gonna help you to follow through quicker. I'm gonna do an open bridge on that shot, like this. So, you know, put your hand, just raise your thumb like there. You have the closed bridge like that, but you can't go as fast away from it. So the open bridge is a personal preference, but I would strongly recommend it. So there you go. Came back quick, but sometimes, you know, if you hit a little more on the right side, it'll kind of hook the rail more and still slow down, but still goes in there. Very difficult shot. It'll take some getting used to it, but once you set it up and once you know how to do it, people will be very truly impressed with that shot. Thanks for watching. That was the Venom Stroke Shot. Stay tuned for more mesque tutorials.